Hey everyone, if you want to start recording music, make podcasts, do streaming, or produce content, you probably heard that you need this mysterious device called audio interface. Hey, I am Maria from Luwit, and today I am going to explain to you what an audio interface is, why you may need one, and how to pick the right one for you. Let's go! Do you want to record vocals, your voice, or an acoustic instrument like a guitar using an XLR microphone? Do you want to record an electric guitar or a synth? Or maybe you just want to play back your recordings in high quality using loudspeakers? If you answered yes to any of these questions, then an audio interface is going to be an excellent investment. Let's start with a rather important detail that you need to know about. Your computer doesn't recognize analog signals.
What?
An audio interface converts analog signals, for example from a microphone or an instrument, into digital format that your computer can recognize. It also works the other way around. Your computer can send digital signals to your audio interface to your headphones or speakers, meaning it can convert digital signal to analog. In short, an audio interface can convert analog signals to digital and digital to analog. Wow, that was a mouthful. Compared to your computer's onboard sound card, an audio interface does this conversion with superior quality. That's why we use an audio interface for recording purposes. Plus, it also offers connectivity your computer doesn't have, for example, an XLR connector for microphones. What audio interface you need depends on what sources and how many you want to record simultaneously, what you like to connect, and if you need your interface for more than just recording, for example, for streaming. In general, make sure your audio interface can provide 48V phantom power for condenser microphones and converts audio with 24 bits/48 kHz to ensure high quality recordings. Let's have a look at the most important connectors of an audio interface. Preamps, mic input, instrument input. This input brings the signal of your microphone or instrument to usable levels using a preamp. It is typically an XLR and jack combo input to connect either a microphone via a 3-pin XLR cable or an instrument. Typically, there's a gain control on the audio interface to determine how strong you want to boost your signal. Some interfaces can even set the gain for you automatically. If you want to record vocals and an instrument at the same time, you will need two of these inputs. If you want to record four sources at the same time, you will need four inputs. And how many inputs do you need if you want to record six sources? Can you guess? That's right, six inputs. Bravo, kids! Please note that line inputs don't always come with a preamp. If you want to use a microphone, the input needs to feature a preamp. I mean, you can use an input without a preamp if you don't want to record anything, so if your vocalist is really bad, that's a pro tip. Headphone output. 6.3mm or 3.5mm jack to connect your headphones to the audio interface. Usually you can set the volume of the headphone output directly on your audio interface. If you want to hear your voice while you're recording with a microphone, you need to use headphones instead of speakers. Otherwise, you're creating a feedback loop. Feedback loop. Feedback loop. Feedback loop. Feedback loop. Balanced line or speaker output. This comes as a 6.3mm jack and typically connects to your active loudspeakers. I hope that you found this video helpful and audio interfaces are not a mystery to you anymore. Remember to like, subscribe and share this video with your friends to motivate us to work. And stay tuned for more. Make yourself heard.